the session titled as Containing China with Mr. Pradip Baijal in conversation with Mr. Shivshankar Menon and Mr. Ashok Kumar Bhattacharya. So to go ahead, let me brief you about our guest for the session, starting with the author and the speaker for this session. Mr. Pradip Baijal is an officer of the Indian Administrative Services who retired as the Chief of the Telecom Regulatory Authority of India. Mr. Baijal held several senior administrative positions in the Ministry of Finance and Industries at state level, but first came into prominence as the Disinvestment Secretary in 1999 and was part of the team that was involved in disinvestment of various government companies like BP, VSNL, IPCL and Maruti. And now, the discussion for the session, Mr. Shivshankar Menon. He is an Indian diplomat who served as National Security Advisor of India under Prime Ministry of Dr. Manmohan Singh. He had previously served as the Foreign Secretary in the Ministry of External Affairs. Prior to that, he was Indian High Commissioner to Pakistan and Sri Lanka and Ambassador to China and Israel. The second discussion for the session is Mr. A.K. Bhattacharya. He is currently the Editorial Director of Business Standard, one of India's best-known financial dailies. He is also a member of the Track to Strategic Dialogues between India and China and between India and Singapore. During his 4 decades in journalism, Mr. Bhattacharya set the bar for business reporting as the Chief of Bureau at the Economic Times in early 1990s. He was the winner of Sri Ram Lifetime Achievement Award for Excellence in Financial Journalism in 2017. I request these gentlemen to please go ahead by unfolding their wonderful conversation, and we must support them with a huge round of applause.
We are here today to discuss a really wonderful and unique book called Containing the China Onslaught by Pradip Baijal. A book that I would very strongly recommend to everyone, because there is no other book like this. There's no other book which actually combines a deep analysis of how China managed to do what she did, which is unprecedented in history, to become a middle-income country within 30 years, from a level where in 1980, at least, both the Indian and the Chinese economies were roughly equal. But also of its implications for the rest of the world, the politics, the geopolitics, the diplomacy, and what India should do about it. So it's a book from an Indian point of view of the most significant development that's happening in our neighborhood and probably in global politics in the last 30 years. Which is why I think it's a book that must be read, because it's a deep book. It's not a quick read, but it is a read that is well worth undertaking. But before we start bombarding him with our questions, Ashok and I thought maybe we should listen to you and ask you to describe the book and tell people basically what I'm trying to say. Please read it.
In the year 1 AD up to 1800 AD, the world did not change. The overall GDP for 1800 years was the same, and the country shares of their GDP were also the same, 1800 years. Things didn't change because there was no technology which could change things. There was no large trade, and the interaction of one country with another was less. But in 1800, a revolution came, and that revolution came in England, the first industrial revolution, 1760, if you recall, and the textile mills came in England, also in Europe, and GDP started changing. India and China, please remember these numbers, India and China were 50% of the world's GDP. 50% of the world's GDP, Sone ki churiya, etc., was India and China. Out of that 50%, India and China, 25-25, one way or the other, nothing happened in the world. And the first technology revolution changed England. Of course, colonial rule was also a cause. England, 1% to 6% in about 70 years. Then came the second industrial revolution. The second industrial revolution was the Ford Motor Company assembly lines, and the cars went from one to another, and you started with the frame, and the car came out at the other end. That technology changed the United States from 5% to 35% in about 100 years.
What are the things that India should be apprehensive about in drawing from China? Yes, a couple of things that you have.
No, I have a straight answer.
Sure.
For 70 years, you have a temporary provision in Kashmir. For 70 years, you have a temporary provision. There is no long-term policy. You read this book. In China, Mao had this 100 years marathon divided into 5 years. And every 5 years, depending on what I have achieved, I change the 5 years. But the 100 years never went wrong. That was not allowed to go wrong. In India, people are saying today, and I am very surprised, that you have given this temporary provision after 70 years, and Narendra Modi has been criticized for that. So that is the psyche of it.
Well, I think we've run across our time. But you can see how many issues there are here in this book, which not only can be debated, but are actually of interest to us all. I think the real parallel for what happened in Kashmir is really Xinjiang in China. And if you look at the effects of that, that's still playing itself out, just as Kashmir is also still playing itself. But there are just so many issues here. What India should do, China's prospects, where will it go now? Can it sustain what it's doing? And all those are in the book. So frankly, either you come outside and we'll continue this discussion.
Thank you so much, Jingle, for being there.